When we got to the mainland, we found the space elevator's support facility. I guess this was the factory where they built the gigantic structure the elevator traveled in. There was this little girl sitting in front of a mural. When the princess saw her, she shuddered like she'd seen a ghost. The girl had a stuffed animal. This was the day after the shit went down at Tyler Island. She walked right up to the princess, took her hand, and led her into the factory. One thing's for sure, they knew each other. The factory'd been converted to a production line for Erusian drones. It was fully automated and chugging along, making drone after drone after drone. Once they got inside, the princess stopped and just stood there. Another girl was there with a man in a lab coat. He was trying to use his keyboard, but she wouldn't let him. She took a data chip and threw it on the ground. Then she walked over to us and took the gun from the prison guard's holster. She pulled the trigger and destroyed the chip. Later, I found out that the girl with the gun and the one with the stuffed animal were sisters. They were also the granddaughters of Mihai A. Shilaji, the legendary pilot. Gramps used to talk about him. He said Mihai was the top ace from two wars ago. Know any Belkans? Because this guy was a Belkan, and they love to stir shit up. Pitting nations against other nations is a particular favorite of theirs, along with developing hyper-advanced technology.
That's right. I'm Belkan, born and raised. My country is gone now. Rather than surrender to its enemy, Belka detonated 7 nuclear weapons on its own soil. My people scattered around the globe, living in the shadows of other countries. We had a new purpose: to breed wars. The theory was that through war, we could achieve our destiny and our revenge. I had just finished inputting Mihai's data when his granddaughter came in. She destroyed the only copy I had of the information I squeezed out of him. The girl loved Mihai. No one knew more than her just how hard I pushed her grandfather for that data, how much I made him sacrifice in the process. I promised his granddaughters that his efforts were not in vain, that it could end this terrible war. But in the end, it only caused more chaos and despair. We were responsible for all this damage, all this tragedy. Now, we were going to pay for it. The Erusians, once our allies, would see to that. I had lost the drive to continue my work, even before I noticed Mihai's granddaughters eyeing me with suspicion that one day. I should have stopped then, for all our sakes. Mihai's granddaughter tossed the gun aside. She said if she resorted to killing, she'd just end up like the rest of us. And by us, she meant everyone, including the princess. Like me, the princess was afraid to look into the girl's eyes. She knew that by encouraging her people, she kept the war going. Mihai and his granddaughter were victims of it. And now, they too were paying the price.
Is this for Belka? Or for Erusia? My grandfather had only one wish: to continue soaring through the endless skies. That was the only place where he felt alive. But I don't even have a country to call home, let alone the sky. The Black Forest, the lake, they are no longer mine. Even though those lands were once cherished by my late mother. We have to learn to put that sense of nostalgia behind us and behave like mature adults.
My homeland. She's right. It feels so far away now. The woman with the rifle approached me. She was focused on more pressing issues.
I checked the computer. All of the data on the legendary ace had already been installed.
No, I pulled it before it was completed. However, there are two aircraft that are already scheduled to be manufactured based on that data.
We must destroy the factory.
This isn't the only one. There are more facilities just like it, and the two planes containing the data will be manufactured at one of those facilities.
So, this place runs on solar power that the space elevator generates, right? How about the others? We can destroy the space elevator and cut the power to them. First things first, let's take this one out.
I'll show you which locations to target.
I stood there, thinking about that mural by the factory's entrance. Harling commissioned it to be painted. I realized that in the background, behind the dancing figures, the artist had painted several space elevators. I understand now. The space elevator wasn't designed to exploit Erugia after all.
Good. And afterwards, we'll bring down the space elevator itself. No matter why it was built, right now, it's the root of this chaos.
I wonder.
Yes?
I wonder which path you would choose when looking at Harling's mirror.
Let's get the briefing started.
We've done enough air operations. Just let us go home.
There's no path for us to get home. Whatever direction you fly, it'll be right into a hail of enemy fire. Earlier, we received a communication via the partially restored general network. Here is what it contained. Apparently, the Erugian radicals have gathered around the space elevator, as it's a source of energy. Give the warmongers a powerful energy source, and you give them the luxury to keep on fighting. In response to this, people from both Osea and Erugia have joined forces and will take down the final arsenal bird in a saturation attack from the air and the sea. Once that's achieved, they'll take the space elevator from the aggressors.
Has the source been verified?
It could be fake. I hear you. Take a look at what's written at the end. Hey, dumbass, if you want to bring the world back from the brink, go to the Lighthouse. You can see the future.
Dumbass? Sounds familiar.
It certainly does. It's from those guys we met in Tyler Island, the 444 Squad. It's a message to all those looking to end the war. But I also think it's a message for Trigger.
Guess we'll do what it says.
Okay. Well then, I'm thinking we go roast that damn bird.
Looks like we're all on the same page. It's time to end this war. Time to fly, guys. Let's go get that arsenal bird.
We need help! Don't let him damage us more! Show them what the Erugian, not what fighter pilots are made of!
Thanks. I owe you.
No sweat.
Get into formation. We have the numbers.
Well, if it isn't the LRSSG, looks like our luck has turned. LRSSG, you will secure air superiority. There are Erugian aircraft in the coalition, so they have been ID'd as friendly via the data link.
Just confirmed it.
The Erugian government aircraft, including drones, will show up as hostiles. You two aces, I think it is time to show us what you've got.
We don't have two anymore. Guess nobody told them.
That's quite true, Count. It's not just two. Wiseman trained his squad well. Everyone still entered as an ace. He'd be proud of you all.
Dwarf, all of you who have gathered here, regardless of your country, this is headquarters of the Ocean Army Southern Command. Wait, don't forget that designation. We are a coalition formed exclusively for the sole purpose of taking down the Arsenal Bird. Wait until we're ready to strike the Arsenal Bird in unison.
Roger.
Brock, don't be speaking on an open channel. The enemy can hear everything he's saying. There's no other choice. The Illusion aircraft are in the coalition as well.
Gold Squadron and Rival Squadron of the Arugian Air Force. We're here on our own. Lancaster, we're entering your airspace.
This is Su-2. Republic of Vosla are also moved to rendezvous. There's only one squadron, though.
It's Mr. Rex's crew.
Count, ease up. Engagement is forbidden.
Don't worry, I know. We need every bird we can call upon. Even if they were flying with the guy that killed Wiseman.
Follow us in Spider 1.
Some of their squadrons are in weird formations.
They have manned aircraft
and
UAVs
in place. All this is just to keep the
war
going. The UAVs were sluggish when the leader went down.
I thought as much. Drones without leaders are slow as hell. The biggest problem is my approach.
How many more do we need to take out?
Shoot them down one at a time. They'll run out eventually.
Picked up a sniper.
Commencing transmission. I'm speaking over both terrestrial broadcasting and video transmission networks. It's not important why... No, not me. First, our goal is twofold. Destroy the space elevator. Second, we want power to the drone factory cut in order to get a stop to all the war and chaos that its products cause. And last, we want to bring an end to this pointless war that has given rise to a state of anarchy. Let me tell you what's going on right now. In spite of that, the war continues to rage overhead.
Impact.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, impact.
How many got caught in that explosion?
Broadcaster, do we have more incoming?
Unknown. Proceed with caution.
We'll come.
Target.
Joshua Bird.
That was close. Without the AWACS, I would have been a goner.
Cosette, that's not the control room. Go through the airlock and get on the maintenance elevator. Get to the top of the windbreak. Do you think you can put on that pressurized suit by yourself? You'll never get it on with those controls.
I'm getting sick of that arrogant bastard, seriously.
No good. The engine control room is gone.
And order to the opposite direction.
Got a radar room here, I think.
Something is missing. Where are we supposed to hit it?
All aircraft. We can no longer commence with a second saturation attack. All aircraft. Separately engage in direct attacks.
HQ, it won't be easy to take down the Oslo Bird with conventional weaponry. All the ace pilots in the world won't save us unless we have a plan.
Give us time. We'll see what we can do.
You're just thinking about it now?
Main propeller one has low stall. Good work, Trigger. Keep up the attack.
Cover any friendlies that hit.
Why did that hit?
It's readying its APS.
Locked on. This one's a goner.
Damn it. I've taken some damage. One aircraft hit. Still killing.
Missile away.
Missile inbound.
I can't see it. Light bulb shaped thing, but it isn't lit up.
That's a location marker.
Is there something we can do? Just beating like this will get us all killed.
Sub-propeller confirmed destroyed.
My target's tail.
Where's that shield gun lose power?
Never. One of the leaders continuously supplies. are saved.
Locked on.
Enemy on your back.
Pulse the laser cannon destroyed. That drops the Arsenal Works threat level a little. Warning, enemy has a beam on you. Laser cannon confirmed destroyed. That is one major threat.
Thanks. That thing almost broke my tail.
Targets in machine gun range.
This is 2-2. Locked on enemy.
Docking module destroyed. That's two of them.
Don't let yourself be distracted. Just focus on what you need to do.
We can do. somehow managed to land. It's your turn now. The carrier ran aground, but that shouldn't be a problem for you. I'll guide you down. 3,000 meters to carrier. You're too fast. Lower your speed. You're on course. Looking good, buddy. 1,500 meters to carrier. Nice work. You pulled off a perfect landing. Well, we're okay for the moment. Now the real challenge begins.
Well, if it isn't the LRSSG, looks like our luck has turned. LRSSG, you'll secure air superiority. There are Russian aircraft in the coalition, so they have been ID'd as friendly via the data link.
Just confirmed it.
The Russian government aircraft, including drones, will show up as hostiles. You two aces, I'm thinking it's time to show us what you've got.
We don't have two anymore. Guess nobody told them.
That's quite true, Count. It's not just two. Wiseman trained his squad well. Everyone still in it as an ace. He'd be proud of you all.
To all of you who have gathered here, regardless of your country, this is headquarters of the Ocean Army Southern Command. Wait, don't forget that designation. We are a coalition formed exclusively for the sole purpose of taking down the Arsenal Bird. Wait until we're ready to strike the Arsenal Bird in unison.
Roger.
Roger. I'm speaking on an open channel. The enemy can hear everything he's saying. There's no other choice. The Russian aircraft are in the coalition as well.
Gold Squadron and Rigel Squadron of the Arusian Air Force. We're here on our own. Lancaster, we're entering your airspace.
This is Sol 2. Republic of Boss Ledger also moving to rendezvous. There's only one squadron, though.
It's Mr. X's crew.
Count, ease up. Engagement is forbidden.
Don't worry, I know. We need every bird we can call upon, even if they were flying with the guy that killed Wiseman. Some of their squadrons are in weird formations.
They have manned aircraft leading UAVs in the flame mode.
All this just to keep a war going. The UAVs were sluggish once the leader went down.
I thought as much. Drones without leaders are slow as hell. The biggest problem is their slave mode.
How many more do we need to take out?
Shoot them down one at a time. They'll run out eventually.
Picked up a sleeper.
Okay. Commencing transmission. I'm speaking over both terrestrial broadcasting and video transmission networks. It's not important who I am. No, who you are. First, our goals. Destroy the space elevator. Second, we want power to the drone factory cut in order to get a stop to all the war and chaos that its products cause. And last, we want to bring an end to this pointless war that has given rise to a state of anarchy. Let me tell you what's going on right now. The land is overrun with refugees who have lost their homes. No isolated incident. In spite of that, the war continues to rage overhead.
Some cargoes of this has turned out to be on. I'll keep talking, babe, once the war's over, too. You can bet on it. We need something or someone to guide us.
Are the Russians rebels or what?
They're rebels, but I'm sure it's more complicated than that. Rush up on Kurnavets later. Focus on the enemy.
Copy that. Take a look. See that line continuing above the horizon? The cable goes up to the sky as far as the eye can see. Transmission tower. In theory, it's radio waves covering exactly half the globe. We've jacked it. infrastructure down, this broadcast can only be transmitted to certain. If you can access the server, consider yourself lucky. You get to see a real-life princess.
From the arsenal burn. Shit, air burst tight. Helios arriving in 10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2. Helios arrived.
Don't fly so close together. I never failed the shot. I'm bailing out.
Inform the coalition units. We're nearing 0 hour.
10 seconds until the united attack on the Arsenal bird.
Damn monster.
Longcaster warning all aircraft. I have multiple blips on my scope.
Here they come.
That's something.
Hey, look at the Arsenal bird.
Lasers!
HQ, we have a problem. The damage to the Allied fleet is extensive.
That was some pretty impressive firepower. I, for one, did not see that coming.
The active protection system operated as expected. We should launch another saturation attack. Air power, yours for the Arsenal bird.
Evade that missile!
Attack missed.
I'm
behind my target.
It's readying its APS. All aircraft, break off from the Arsenal bird.
Enemy's got locked.
That was close. Without the
A-Wing,
I would have been a goner. That's
not the control room. Go through the airlock and get on the maintenance elevator. Get to the top of the windbreak. Do you think you can put on that pressurized suit by yourself? You won't ever get it on with those wheels. Yes! Smash it! Smash all six of the bastards! It'll lose power!
pray it isn't damaged.
Good luck.
Leave it to Trigger.
Don't let it down, Player One. Thank you.